from one holiday season and head toward the new year. Coming up in just under a week, we'll be in 1999. That means one thing. Starcade is tomorrow night. Washington, D.C. at the MCI Center. It's Nash and Goldberg for all the marbles.
Well, Scott, happy holidays to you as well as everyone watching WCW Saturday Night this evening here on the Superstation. You know, and it's time to do it. It's time to synchronize watches.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see, it's just after 6 o'clock Eastern time, just past 6:05, which means to me that we are now inside 26 hours to the granddaddy of them all, the night that we've been waiting for, Starrcade 98, the world's heavyweight title matchup, Goldberg putting the belt, putting the unbeaten streak on the line against Kevin Nash. Plus, the match is no longer in question.
Oh, yeah.
It's set. It's official. Ric Flair against Eric Bischoff.
Ric Flair came back last Monday night at the TWA Dome in St. Louis. We will revisit what happened in old St. Louis later here on Saturday night. We start off with Norman Smiley. And remember,
wait a minute. What'd you call him?
I was going to say, it's no longer Norman Smiley.
Well,
I can't do it justice. You go.
Well, he claims that when he is seen outside of a Waffle House, oftentimes wrestling fans will come up to him and call him Norman Smiley. But that's not the proper pronunciation. I mean, this is a man from Europe, from London, England, and he wants to be known now as
Norman Smiley. Is that close?
That's pretty close. It's about as good as we're going to get, I think.
Whoa, that's a pretty good drop kick from Nick Densmore on Norman Smiley. And a forearm from Densmore. Shoots him across, waits on him. Oh, but Smiley. Kick right into the side of the head. Full scoop slam coming up.
Whoa!
With authority in the center of the ring. And Smiley in control here on Saturday night.
You know, don't you just love the way that he takes his opponent up into the air for that power slam? And then with that extra burst of energy, that authority, drives him down to the mat. Tonight's opposition provided by a young man, a rookie, by the name of Nick Densmore. And Nick Densmore has his work cut out for the charismatic Norman Smiley.
Schoolboy roll-up, cradles him, got the two count on Smiley. Oh, ducks under the clothesline. Back elbow from Smiley. Good night.
Oh, he nailed him that time, didn't he, with the elbow?
Hey, later on Saturday night, Mean Gene Okerlund will have an exclusive interview with the Lone Wolf, Scott Hall. How often do we hear from Scott Hall that he's not in the ring taking a survey or whatnot? Okerlund and Hall, one-on-one interview still to come on this program.
Well, that's going to be great. There's so much talk, so much speculation that Scott Hall has been doing everything within his power to try and align himself with the NWO Red and Black, with the Wolfpack. But at least to this point, Scott Hall is a man without an organization, without a faction attached to him. Quick cover now by Smiley and gets a two count. And I think that Scott Hall's future in professional wrestling, I think as far as he's concerned, he's going to need to align himself with one of these organizations. And in the terms of NWO Black and White, at least from what we've heard from the new leader, Scott Steiner, that's not going to be the group that he's going to be aligned with.
Well, Big Papa Pump has told us that the NWO Black and White will start to take on more of a Scott Steiner-like feel. Scott Hall didn't like that and bam. Hang on, sunset flip from Densmore. Can he get Smiley over? Powering him, Smiley hanging on. No.
Got him.
One, two. Oh, and Smiley out at two. That was so close. But Smiley comes back. Oh, tag Densmore. Slap across the back of Densmore and Smiley in control here on the Superstation.
Well, Norman is a very accomplished wrestler, as he puts it, on every continent, not just here in the States with World Championship Wrestling. His background extends to Mexico, to Japan, as well as Europe, and he can use so many different variations and styles in the ring. Nice scoop and a slam.
Smiley under the ropes, little extra momentum, ducked out. Densmore rolled out from the elbow, and Smiley hit hard. That may have given him a stinger in there. Densmore takes advantage, forearm to Smiley. Another, shoots Smiley across in the middle. Smiley, oh, what a backdrop from Densmore. What an upset this would be if Densmore could score the pinfall on Smiley.
Well, great elevation with the back body drop by Densmore. The reversal, the slide through.
Standing switch, go behind, full Nelson. Reversal by Densmore. Oh! and Dinsmore went throat first into that top steel cable. Compliments of Smiley.
Now that's the experience of the veteran showing there. Hooks on the chicken wing.
That's it. That's the Norman Conquest. With the Norman Conquest, can Dinsmore hang on? No. Referee Billy Silverman calls for the bell, and Dinsmore goes down, and Smiley, Smiley, will get the victory on Saturday night.
Well, a quick tap out that time by Nick Dinsmore, and you can't blame him. Perfect ring position on the part of Norman Smiley. Had the chicken wing hold hooked in place.